Today on Upfront, rules that say public employees must live where they work. Is it an issue of local control or freedom of choice? Then, politics, business, and beer. New Glarus's Deb Carey on her booming brewery and those rumors that she's interested in running for governor. Plus, the changes coming to a popular outdoor center, the new mission at McKenzie Environmental Education Center, and why it's needed. It's all this week on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Gouchet.
Hello and welcome to Upfront. Mike Gouchet is off this week. I'm Kent Wainscott. Some 120 Wisconsin municipalities have a residency requirement. The best known residency rule is in the state's biggest city. Milwaukee requires all public employees to live in the city. But Governor Walker proposed lifting the residency requirement statewide in his budget. If it goes through, there are concerns about what happens for cities big and small.
Are you concerned that there's going to be that sort of flight from Milwaukee?
Obviously, I'm concerned about that.
Milwaukee Mayor Tom Barrett is blunt. He says Governor Walker's plan to repeal residency requirements would hurt the city.
People are dreaming if they don't think that having a flood of houses on the market is going to drive down property values. It is going to have an impact on property values.
Governor Walker says Milwaukee's residency rule should be lifted to help the city's school district.
In performance, in particular, Milwaukee has a tremendous challenge, not just this year, but many years in the past, finding enough qualified teachers to teach within the Milwaukee public school system. One of the barriers I mentioned repeatedly in the past has been the residency requirement.
But the issue goes beyond Milwaukee. Dozens of smaller Wisconsin communities have residency requirements, including the city of Wisconsin Dells. The Dells mayor wrote to the governor asking that the residency rules stay in place. He says it helps make public employees more invested in the communities they serve.
It's local control. What we do in Wisconsin Dells is our business with our employees. The same thing as what Superior does or what O'Connell County does or what the city of Milwaukee does. They should have local control of their employees.
We're discussing the residency rule repeal today with two state lawmakers. Republican Representative John Jagler of Watertown supports the repeal. Democratic Representative LaTonya Johnson of Milwaukee supports keeping residency rules. Thank you both very much for being with us today.
Representative Jagler, let me begin
with you. This residency rule has been in place in Milwaukee and other communities around the state for decades because those communities believe it works best for them. Why should the state step in and deny those communities the right to determine what works best?
You know, when it comes to local control, I'm very much in favor of that to a most part. But when it comes to individual freedom, I think that trumps this. And I just think it's time for this issue to be revisited. I'm glad it's being talked about. Now it's been kicked around the Capitol for years. It's time to make this go away. The term archaic is being used a lot. I don't know if we'd go there, but I think it's time for it to be taken a much closer look at.
So if it's an ideological argument and there isn't any real fiscal impact, should it be part of the budget?
You know, there's always the talk of policy in the budget, and I don't know that it should, to be honest with you. And the fact is, Governor Walker decided it's there, and here we go. If the big push comes and it's removed from the budget and talked about as a separate bill, I'd be fine with that. I'd be happy to co-sponsor it. But here it is, and here we go. Let's have this discussion. It's clear, by the way, that the argument would be, well, it's not getting, if it's in the budget, it's not going to get a vetting. Well, here we are talking about it, you know, this far out from the budget even being finalized. I think it is going to get vetted one way or the other. So,
Representative Johnson, should people have the right to live where they want to live?
I don't believe that this is a matter of freedom. Being a public employee it's not an entitlement. It's a requirement as part of your job description. Both Representative Jagler and myself, we both have residency requirements. We both live in the districts in which we serve. And before I ran, I owned a business in the district in which I served. And it gave me a vested interest in that community. I think municipalities and taxpayers have every right to expect the employees that they pay their salaries reinvest that money within the communities in which they live.
You heard Governor Walker make reference to Milwaukee Public Schools as one of the reasons that he is pushing for this. MPS is a district with unique challenges. Mm-hmm. There are hundreds of teacher openings now that they have to fill. Lifting the residency requirement would open that up to an entirely new pool of candidates for them, people who may be good teachers who could help the district, but maybe who don't want to uproot their families and move them to Milwaukee. Wouldn't this help MPS to lift that requirement?
I think we have to look at the numerous reasons that MPS has vacancies, one of which was Act 10. We took away their work environment rights, and then we underfunded their classrooms. And now a lot of teachers are making a mad dash for retirement because they're afraid of losing their pensions and their health care. So in large parts, we helped to create a lot of those vacancies. And for this to be a statewide issue is very unfair to the municipalities and the taxpayers that pay these salaries.
There's also a question about first responders having to live near or in the communities that they serve. And we spoke with Doug Holton, who is an associate dean of protective services at Madison Area Technical College. He is the former fire chief in Milwaukee, which has a residency requirement, and St. Paul, Minnesota, which doesn't. And we asked him whether he thought it was more important for first responders to live in the community that they serve. Here's what he had to say.
I believe that it's in the best interest of any municipality to have their public, their police and fire close, either in the community or very near the community.
Well, former Chief Holton says that having first responders live in the community, having a residency requirement for them, worked in Milwaukee and would work in other communities. What's your take on first responders?
Well, the first thing that I did when I saw this in the budget was contact my locals in the 37th Assembly District. Watertown's Police Department does have a residency requirement, a bit of a hybrid. You get a little bit of comfort outside of town. And I asked the police chief, I went in and talked to the police chief. I said, where are you on this? Is this an issue for you guys when it comes to emergency and first responders? He said, no, it's not, because the truth of the matter is, when there is an emergency, we rely on mutual aid. And most of the districts in Wisconsin do that. The mutual aid from other districts of officers on call is the first call in. And his take on it is, look, I want to be able to hire the best and the brightest. I don't care where they are coming from as long as they get to work on time. That was his take on it, and I happen to agree with that. You've seen time and time again the maps of where officers or where firefighters are placed compared to where their actual precinct is. A lot of times, if they were allowed the freedom to go outside the city to one of the suburbs, they'd be even closer to where they're working. So
one of the principal opponents of this, as we heard earlier, is Mayor Tom Barrett in Milwaukee. He talks about concerns over what will happen to this city and its economic base if the residency requirements are lifted. What do you think will happen in Milwaukee?
I'm concerned about that issue too. I have 5 foreclosures on my block. And public employees tend to have middle class jobs. And this is not the time for us to encourage our middle class to relocate. Over 60% of this city's budget is spent on fire and police. And we need those individuals to help sustain our neighborhoods, especially in a time where the average taxpayer is having a hard enough time maintaining the value of their home. In 2011, 84% of public employees were known to be living in owner-occupied dwellings. So this is a huge, huge concern for us.
Should MPS or any school district be separated from first responders? Should they be treated differently when it comes to residency requirements?
Well, just back to the mayor's comments, I mean, one thing that I've learned in the few months I've been on the job in the Capitol, being an elected official, a couple of years working in the Speaker's office prior, Speaker Fitzgerald, is never underestimate the ability of Mayor Barrett or Walker's opponents to over-exaggerate things. We were told in Act 10 that the classroom sizes would explode. Didn't happen. We were told with the mining debate just last week, we were told that I was accused of genocide because I supported that. I was accused of destroying the planet. We were told with concealed carry that it was going to be wild, wild west. None of this has happened. This mass exodus that he's concerned about, they can't just disappear. These people are homeowners. They're going to want to get the best value from their home. It's going to take them time if they decide to take that step.
But we have seen it happen in other cities.
In other cities, though, haven't. Cleveland didn't have as big as a mass exodus as other communities had feared. And you look at this, to me, it shows what he actually, what is he afraid of? Is he that scared that people are going to flee this city? To me, the focus should be put on, rather than putting people behind this wall, to improving the city so they want to stay, so they want to come.
There's been some debate, even among Republicans in the leadership in the legislature, about this. Real quickly, will this stay in the budget, or will it be broken out, and will it pass?
It will pass. Whether it stays in the budget, I don't know. I'll have to wait on the fiscal note from the fiscal department on whether it actually is a fiscal issue as far as justifying it being in the budget. I don't
Representative
know.
Representative Johnson, this real quickly,
is,
your take.
This is not an issue for the state to take up. This is an issue for the municipalities and the taxpayers. This should not be in the budget.
And the debate goes on. I appreciate your time. Thank you very much, both of you, for being here, Representatives Jagler and Johnson. And next, the woman behind Wisconsin's popular Spotted Cow beer, New Glarus's Deb Carey, on meeting with the president and the success of her brewery. And later, thousands of children learn about the great outdoors at the McKenzie Center near Poinette, why the DNR wants to change the center, when Up Front continues.
Up Front with Mike Gouche, brought to you by American Transmission Company.